even just a normal Friday morning to just send your kid off on the bus and to not be able to pick them home, you know? And that, I ached for them, you know?
For the students in April Gerald's broadcast class at Fontainbleau High School, what happened last Friday at Sandy Hook Elementary hit both home and heart. Knowing that the kids would need supplies and support as they moved to a different building, these kids went right to work.
And they're, of course, going to need new materials and new books to read. And, of course, to kind of take away some of those painful memories and bring in some new ones that they can hopefully have.
Gift-wrapped picture books, rays of light and hope for kids fractured by tragedy their innocence simply can't fathom. And cards, personal words of encouragement from a group who, like the rest of us, can't understand it either. What you say in your card?
This one, I said, don't forget God gives his hardest battles to his toughest soldiers.
Wow.
I mean, where more could you feel safe than at school? And now I think that that innocence is shaken some from these kids.
Allie Mathis has personal connection, family.
I started thinking about my cousins and my aunt and uncle because they live like 5 minutes away from there. And so my thoughts like immediately went to them.
These kids are reaching out to let the kids in Connecticut know that somebody cares about them, that they will get through this, that we are all God's children and everybody is related in some way, shape, or form.
While administrators across the North Shore continue their own quest to keep students safe and secure, this group reaches out to the kids at Sandy Hook.
But I started off with a joke, and it was, what did the ocean say to the shore? Nothing, it just waved.
And that's why I think we're here today, like trying to bring this light back to them and make them smile again after they've seen the worst of the world.
At a time when so many are wondering what should be done in the wake of Sandy Hook, these students already know. A thought, a prayer, and a thousand-mile hug.
Oh, my back.
It's what families do. On your side on the North Shore, Heath Allen, WDSU News.
Wonderful story. And a letter went out with St. Tammany students tonight letting parents know that support services are available for their kids. The school system will also review its safety procedures to see if anything else could be put into place.